Hello, I'm Ishan Desai, and a warm welcome from my side. I'm a pre-sized developer working at the University of Stuttgart. Today, I will talk about the Phoenix adapter in the pre-sized project. So for those of you who don't know what Phoenix is, I will start with introducing Phoenix, then talk about the Phoenix pre-sized adapter and its details and how it is used, followed by a couple of examples of coupled problems where Phoenix is one of the participants, and in the end I will showcase how to get the Phoenix adapter and how to possibly contribute in the repository. Phoenix is a finite element computing platform. It is an open source project and its main function is to solve arbitrary partial differential equations using the finite element method. Phoenix has a high-level API, which is in a very abstract form and is available in both Python and C++. For the purposes of this work and the examples that I show, the work is done mainly with the Python API of Phoenix. Phoenix has a lot of functionalities and is a big project, but there are a few worth mentioning. The ability to generate and manage meshes with prescribed finite elements. A wide range of finite elements are available for use in Phoenix. Defining the weak form of the arbitrary partial differential equation in a compact notation that's very easy to understand. Solving the variational problem using a single command, and applying and modifying data on the nodal elements of the meshes of the finite elements that we have previously prescribed. The Phoenix project has several sub-packages like Dolphin, FFC, Fiat, and more. In this work, we use solely the core Phoenix package. It is worth to note that the new development with respect to Phoenix is being done in a new software called Phoenix X. Here is an example of a structural problem solved using Phoenix. An elastic beam is deformed under load. This is part of a fluid structure interaction problem, which is solved with pre-size, which will be discussed later on. After the very brief introduction to Phoenix, let's move on and try to understand the Phoenix pre-sized adapter. The goal of developing this adapter was to provide a helper package to a Phoenix user so that the user can set up a coupling problem using pre-size. Some of the design principles of this adapter are as follows. The main intention is to have a middle layer between a very high-level Phoenix program file and the low-level C++ pre-sized API. As the Phoenix code itself is written in Python, the adapter uses the Python bindings of pre-sized to connect to the low-level C++ API. The other design principle was to have a highly modular structure, which is easy to understand and modify in the future. The intention to have a modular structure is also to increase readability so that experienced Phoenix users can easily understand the code and modify it. The main task of the adapter is to handle as many non-Phoenix tasks as possible within itself. For example, conversion of data structures from a Phoenix format to a pre-sized format and vice versa is handled inside the adapter. These non-Phoenix tasks are explicit tasks which come in especially when setting up a coupling problem with Phoenix. Some of the features of the adapter. The adapter supports two-dimensional cases in Phoenix. The users can define boundary conditions using the Phoenix Expression class or the Phoenix Point Source class. In cases of point source, multiple point sources can be defined. The adapter additionally needs a JSON file for its configuration. This file needs to be provided by the user. The figure on the right briefly explains the working of the adapter and its connection to pre-sized and the Phoenix program. The user will mainly concentrate on the solver.py file, which is located in this dark blue box here. This file imports functionality from Phoenix and is the main working file where the user will solve the problem. The orange block, which is the connection between pre-sized and the solver.py, is the Phoenix pre-sized adapter. This adapter is the main connection line directly between pre-sized and the solver.py file of the user. The adapter imports functionalities from pre-sized and the Python bindings of Presize and also from Phoenix to be the helper package for the user. As already mentioned, the adapter additionally needs a JSON configuration file, and this file contains various information like the name of the participant or the name of the mesh or the name of the XML configuration file which Presize needs. This figure also shows that once the connection to Presize is done, the coupling is performed by Presize with the other side. This coupling can be done with, for example, OpenFoam, SU2, or other software codes. To use the adapter in a Phoenix program, the user needs to call certain adapter functions at particular intervals in the main Phoenix program script. The adapter receives the configuration information from a JSON file. The path to this JSON file needs to be supplied at the time of defining the adapter. Then the adapter needs to be initialized. In initialization, the user needs to supply a subdomain object which carries the geometric information about the coupling boundary. Along with this, the user also needs to supply function space objects relevant to the read data and the write data which needs to be used in the coupling. Using these function space objects and the subdomain objects, the adapter retrieves all the relevant geometric data of the coupling boundary. The adapter also handles the data conversion from a Phoenix format to a Presize format and vice versa in the functions read data and write data. The data defined at the coupling boundary can be of the form of a Phoenix expression object or a collection of Phoenix point source objects. The user needs to define this once at the start. This is done using the create coupling expression functions provided in the adapter. Once the expression is defined, it's modified again and again with the modified data which is received from Presize. An important feature of the adapter is that the distributed parallelization in Phoenix, which is done with MPI, is completely handled out of the box while the data mapping and interpolation is done. Checkpointing functionality is also available in the adapter in the form of two functions, store checkpoint and retrieve checkpoint, for implicit coupling. Here is a code snippet of a typical Phoenix program. At the start, various functionalities from Phoenix are imported. Then a mesh is defined, following which a boundary definition is done. Once the mesh and the boundary are defined, the function space on which the finite elements live is defined. In the function space definition, the type of the elements and the degree can be specified. After this, the trial and the test functions are defined. The trial and the test functions are used to later on define the weak form of the partial differential equation. After this, the boundary condition of the physical problem is defined in the form of an expression, which is then used to define the actual boundary condition. The boundary condition, as an example shown here, is the Dirichlet boundary condition. Once these definitions are done, the initial condition is defined and then the actual weak form of the PDE is defined. After this, the solve command is run to solve the variational problem. The code snippet on the right shows the modifications necessary to a Phoenix program to use the Phoenix adapter for a coupled problem. Along with various import statements relevant to Phoenix, the adapter class from the Phoenix Presize package also needs to be imported. The Phoenix Presize package is nothing but the Phoenix adapter in the form of a Python package. In the mesh and the boundary definition, an additional coupling boundary needs to be defined. Usually, along with the boundary data, more data needs to be defined. As an example here, the flux definition is shown, which lives on a vector function space. This is done when a Dirichlet-Neumann coupling is done. So the Dirichlet participant is the Dirichlet expression, and the Neumann participant will then be a function which lives on the vector function space. Once the relevant data are defined, the adapter is defined. The path to the JSON configuration file of the adapter is given. After that, the adapter is initialized. In the initialization, the coupling boundary, needs to be supplied and also the relevant function spaces on which the read and the write functions live need to be given. Then the coupling expression, so the Phoenix expression object which defines the boundary condition at the coupling boundary, needs to be defined. After its initial definition, the initial condition and the weak form is again defined, and then the steering of the problem is given to Presize. Before solving the actual problem, data is read from Presize using the adapter function readData. After the data has been received from Presize, the coupling expression at the coupling boundary is updated with this data. Once this update is done, the problem is solved. After solving the problem, the relevant data which needs to be written back to Presize is extracted. Once this data is available, the adapter write data command is used to write this data to Presize. And once both the reading and writing is done, the advanced command of the adapter is called. This is a very basic example of how the script of a Phoenix program needs to be modified for an explicit coupling application for a coupled problem with Presize. In the event that implicit coupling needs to be done, additional commands regarding checkpointing need to be added in the last part. This is an example of a conjugate heat transfer coupling problem with Phoenix and the CFD code OpenFOAM. In this problem, there is a fluid domain which is touching a solid plate which is at a higher temperature. The solid plate is simulated using Phoenix. So Phoenix solves a heat transport problem and OpenFOAM solves the fluid side. The fluid problem has a inlet velocity on the left side. At the bottom, you see the result plot. In the result, we have smooth temperature contour plots, which show that the coupling is physically valid. It is worth to note that this is a Dirichlet-Neumann coupling. Phoenix reads temperatures from the OpenFOAM side and writes heat fluxes to OpenFOAM. And in the reverse direction, OpenFOAM reads the heat fluxes and writes temperatures back. The second example is a fluid structure interaction coupling with Phoenix and the CFD code SU2. In this example, an elastic beam is placed vertically in a fluid domain. The beam is fixed at the bottom. The fluid domain has an inflow velocity prescribed at the left boundary. Due to the velocity, the fluid domain has flow, and this imparts forces onto this vertical beam. The beam displaces under the forces. Phoenix solves the structural problem, that is, Phoenix reads these forces from the fluid domain and calculates displacements and writes the displacement back to the fluid domain. So the flap deforms under these forces. This deformation is clearly seen in the results on the right side. Here you see the flap deformed after a certain point of time in the simulation, and the fluid domain mesh, the SU2 mesh, has also correspondingly deformed. Both the examples shown earlier are part of the tutorials repository in Presize, meaning that in the tutorials repository you can find the case setups for both the cases of the conjugate heat transfer and fluid structure interaction done with Phoenix. Getting the Phoenix adapter is quite easy. The adapter is maintained under an open source license in the repository Phoenix adapter within the Presize project on GitHub. The adapter is easy to install with pip, just by running pip3 install Phoenix Presize. The latest release can be found within the releases section of the Phoenix adapter. Other dependencies such as SciPy, NumPy, Cython, MPI4Py are installed automatically during the adapter installation. The dependencies are Python, Presize, obviously, Phoenix, and most importantly, the Python bindings for Presize. The Python bindings can also be installed with pip by pip3 install --user pypresize. Here is a short summary of my talk. Phoenix Presize is an adapter, is used to couple Phoenix with other simulation codes using Presize. Currently, the adapter supports 2D Phoenix cases. Phoenix data structures, and the distributed parallelization in Phoenix is handled automatically in this adapter. The adapter is modular and flexible in design, and installation is straightforward using pip. If someone wishes to contribute to this adapter, there are various ways to do that. Some of the topics of contribution are mentioned here. Extending the adapter to handle 3D Phoenix cases is an upcoming feature. Implementing multiple coupling interface handling, and also to modify the adapter to support Phoenix X and Dolphin X. Phoenix X and Dolphin X are the upcoming new APIs for the Phoenix project. A good place to start contributing is to have a look at the current issues in the Phoenix adapter repository. Thank you for your attention, and I look forward to your questions.